Officials say the female trainer was in the whale holding area when she apparently slipped. But a witness says the whale jumped up and grabbed the trainer by the waist. What are you hearing?
Well, since that time, SeaWorld has actually come forward and admitted that the whale, in fact, dragged her into the water. Just after noon today, she was rubbing the whale's stomach after a short meet and greet, a private event that they do after the show. That's when the whale grabbed her, dragged her into the water, kind of thrashed her around a little bit, took her under. Some of the people that were underneath in the viewing area, watching through the glass, actually saw this, and then that's when she drowned.
So that was in a thing they do where people pay a little extra and get a private thing, right?
Exactly. After the show, it's called Dining with Shamu, I think it's called. They have a lunch and they get to interact with the trainer and get to watch a little bit closer up, pay a little bit extra money to see a closer show.
Let's listen to a witness account, which is different from what SeaWorld says happened. Let's hear what the witness says.
And then Talikum just took off like a bat out of you know where, just took off really fast, and then he came back around to the glass, jumped up, and grabbed the trainer by the waist, and started shaking her violently.
Well, I think that's what they're now saying. Lori and Scott Miller, you saw what, an earlier show?
Yes, the main show was called Believe, and that's the show that most people are familiar with, where the Shamu whales come and jump out of the water and splash everyone in the splash soak zone. And there was a disturbance during that show. The event actually happened after the show, but the whales...
What was the disturbance?
The whales weren't behaving. They weren't following the instructions, and the senior trainer actually came out onto the stage to let the crowd know shortly after they had done the soak zone part that the whales decided they were having more fun splashing each other than splashing the crowd. And it seemed like a statement that she had prepared to sort of vamp while they regrouped. And she told us that the whales needed to calm down and decide, because we don't tell them what to do, we ask them to perform for us. And if they don't want to, we don't force them.
Scott, did the crowd understand that?
They seemed to. Mm-hmm. They seemed to. They were quite clear. They told us they brought a couple of the whales out to the back tanks to regroup, to actually watch how they swim, which dictates what they'll do next in the program.
Mm-hmm. They said their Dawn swimming Branshaw, pattern needs to calm down.
Dawn Branshaw, who was killed today, was interviewed by CNN in 2008 for a Miles O'Brien report about transportation at SeaWorld. Take a look.
When Dawn Branshaw is at work, she has a very low carbon fin print. And now her trip to and from Shamu's crib at SeaWorld is a little easier on the environment as well.
It's one small but really big way that we're trying to make an impact.
Boy. Drew, is SeaWorld closed for a while now?
I know that at least that part of the park is going to be closed. Right when this happened, they kind of sectioned off that area of the park. But no word on if they're going to close for a long period of time. My guess is that they probably won't.